Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Growth Therapy. Assalamu alaikum viewers, hope you are doing well. Today I will explain about the course which name is Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Growth Course offered by Taseer DawaKhana Private Limited. This course is prepared for will recover their male infertility problem in few months. In today's program, I will brief you about what is Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Growth Course, how it can cure the disease male infertility, why male infertility happens, its symptoms, reason of this disease, indications, male infertility types, complete detail about the sperm quality and quantity. First of all, we should know that what is male infertility. This is the problem causing inability to conceive live with the male partner. It is termed male infertility. More than 7% of the male in sexually active age group of underage 45 of the age were diagnosed with the infertility problems in the world year 2019. 14% were diagnosed with sperm related problems and 6% with varicose. Fertility in males is evaluated by checking sperm count, sperm motility, ability to move, and sperm morphology. These abnormalities result in male infertility. There may be nothing wrong with the sperm, but blockage in the sperm ducts that are making it impossible for the couples to conceive. What are the symptoms of male infertility? The main sign of male infertility is the inability to conceive a child. There may be no other obvious sign or symptoms. But in some cases, an underlying problem such as inherited disorder or hormonal imbalance, dilated veins around the testicle, or a condition that blocks the passage of the sperm causes signs and symptoms. Although most men with male infertility do not notice symptoms other than the ability to conceive a child. Signs and symptoms associated with male infertility includes problems with sexual function, for example, difficulties in ejaculation or small volumes of fluid ejaculated, reduced sexual desire, difficult retaining erections, pain, swelling or a lump in the testicle area, recurrent respiratory infection, inability to smell, decreased facial or body hairs, or other signs of a chromosomal or hormonal abnormality. A lower than normal sperm count, fewer than 15 million sperm per milliliter of a semen, or a total sperm count less than 39 million per ejaculate. Causes: male infertility is a complex process to get your partner pregnant. You must produce healthy sperm. Initially, this involves the growth and formation of the male reproductive organs. During the puberty, at least one of your testicles must be functioning correctly and your body must be produced testosterone and other hormones to trigger the maintain sperm production. Sperm have to be carried into the semen. Once sperm are produced in the testicle, delicate tubes transport them until they mix with the semen and are ejaculated out of the penis. There needs to be enough sperm in the semen. If the number of the sperm in your semen is low, it decreases the odds that one of your sperm will fertilize your partner's egg. A low sperm count is fewer than 15 million sperm per milliliter of a semen or fewer than 39 million per ejaculate. Sperm must be functional and be able to move. If the movement or function of the sperm is abnormal, the sperm may not be able to reach or penetrate your partner's egg. Hormones play an important role in disease. Male infertility, there are several hormones which affect on a person for producing a child, like testosterone, luteinizing hormones, follicle stimulating hormones. Luteinizing hormone is a gonadotropin that is released by the pituitary glands in the response to luteinizing hormone releasing hormone. Abbreviated LH in males, LH controls the length. Abbreviated LH in females, LH controls the length and sequence of the female menstrual cycle, including ovulation, preparation of the uterus from implantation of the fertilized egg, and ovulation production of the both estrogen and progesterone. In males, LH stimulates the testes to produce androgen, also known as interstitial cell stimulating hormones. For males, the normal range of luteinizing hormone LH is 1.24 till 7.8 international units per milliliter. If luteinizing hormone LH levels are below the normal range, it may indicate a pituitary gland problem. The pituitary gland may not be making enough luteinizing hormone, which may lead to low testosterone. In general, the normal testosterone range in males is about 270 to 1070 nanograms per deciliter, with an average level of 679 nanograms per deciliter. A normal male testosterone level peaks at about age 20, and then it slowly declines. Testosterone level above or below the normal range are considered by many to be out of balance. Follicle stimulating hormone FSH is one of the gonadotropic hormone, the other being luteinizing hormone. Both are released by the pituitary gland into the bloodstream. Follicle stimulating hormone is one of the hormones essential for pubertal development and function of the women's ovaries and men's testes. In women, this hormone stimulates the growth of ovarian follicle in the ovary before the release of an egg from one's follicle at ovulation. It also increases estradiol production in men. Follicle stimulating hormone acts on the Sertoli cells of the testes to stimulate sperm production. Normal follicle stimulating hormones FSH level in adult men are typically between 1.24, 1.5 till 12.4 international units per milliliter. A high follicle stimulating hormone level in a male may mean that testicles are not functioning correctly, while low follicle stimulating hormone FSH level in male may indicate problems with the pituitary gland in the brain. There are two types of infertility, primary and secondary. Primary infertility is the ability to conceive a child after regular intercourse for at least 1 year, while secondary infertility occurs in couples who have previously been pregnant at least once but are unable to conceive another pregnancy. As per medical research, in 50 to 60% of infertile cases, male have infertility problem. A number of causes exist for male infertility that may result in impaired sperm count or mobility or impaired ability to fertilize the egg. The most common cause of male infertility includes abnormal sperm production or function, impaired delivery of sperm production, condition related to a man's general health and lifestyle, and overexposure to certain environmental elements. Now I am going to tell you the types of disease. We were semen producing testicle. Testicles are very important in sperm production. If testicles are not working well, then it makes a problem. There are two types of testicle disease. First one is hydrocele and the second one is varicocele. A hydrocele is a type of swelling in the scrotum that occurs when the fluid collects in a thin sheet surrounding a testicle. Hydrocele is common in newborn and usually disappears without the treatment by age 1. Older boys and adult men can develop a hydrocele due to inflammation and aging in the scrotum. And the second is varicocele. A varicocele is an enlargement of the vein within the loose bag of skin that holds your testicle. A varicocele is similar to a varicose vein you might see in your legs. Varicoceles are the common cause of low sperm production and decreased sperm quality, which can cause infertility. Viewers, now I will tell you about the sperm disease. There are three types of sperm disease named as Azoospermia, Oligospermia, and Nicrospermia. The first one is Azoospermia. It is a medical condition of a man whose semen contains no sperm. It is associated with infertility, but many forms are amenable to medical treatment. Azoospermia's main cause is infection. It includes pus cell in semen, blood in semen, presence of bacteria. This condition does not have any symptoms. Azoospermia is further divided into two more types, obstructive and non-obstructive azoospermia. Obstructive azoospermia is defined as absence of spermatozoa in the ejaculate despite normal spermatogenesis. Obstructive azoospermia is a common urologic condition as accounts for 6.1% to 13.6% of patients presenting for the fertility evaluation. Non-obstructive azoospermia is defined as no sperm in the ejaculate due to a failure of the spermatogenesis and is the most severe form of male fertility. Second type is oligospermia. This is a male fertility issue characterized by a low sperm count. Other aspects of the sexual health of men with this condition are typical. This includes the ability to get and maintain an erection as well as produce ejaculation at orgasm. Sperm count in the ejaculate can vary throughout your life. As I explained, the normal sperm count is between 200 to 600 million. So if a person has less than 120 million sperm count, then he has oligospermia. This disease is because of infection in the vein, physical disturbance, anxiety, and the abnormal hormone level. Now I will tell you about the third infertility disease, which is called necrospermia. Necrospermia is a condition in which there is a low percentage of life and very much percentage of immortal spermatozoa in the semen. It can be diagnosed by a semen analysis with fertility staining performed to determine whether the sperm are dead or alive and immortal. Because of this, men are unable to make a woman pregnant. There are some conditions required for pregnancy. 50 to 60% have active mortality. Good health is essential for both men and women. Male semen has normal sperm count. If a person is not meeting this general criteria, then he is not able to produce a child or make a woman pregnant. After every 72 hours, men should produce 1.5 to 5 milliliters semen. When a normal person ejaculates, then he releases 200 to 600 million of sperms. If he has 50 million or less than 50 million active sperms, then he is not able to produce a child. Viewers, a man produces 50,000 sperms in a minute, 72 million in a day. These sperms get mature in 84 days. Infertility may be occurred because of different sperm diseases. Special impacts. Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Grow Course has some special herbs. Those qualities to achieve confidence and sexual satisfaction experience, which is specially prepared for those who has erectile dysfunction, ejaculation, duration problems, stiffness with penis. It is very safe and easy to use, made with 100% pure herbal extracts. Taseer DawaKhana has been established since 1946 and you can recover from all diseases by using Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Grow Course by Taseer DawaKhana, which is made with special herbs and free from any side effect. Doctor and scientist of our institute, Taseer DawaKhana, worked under the supervision of Kimo Dr. Tariq Mahmood Taseer. Qualified doctors, leading doctors, pharmacists, and a key paper on research. Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Grow Course is chemical-free natural supplement with no side effect. It is prepared from 100% pure herbs and effective. Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Grow Course cures azoospermia, oligospermia, necrospermia, varicocele, hydrocele, pus cell, infection, hormone level, maintain pH level of a person, increase the volume of the semen, thickness in semen, sperm morphology, every type of infection, and start producing sperm where the person may be relieved from all infertility needs. Increase HGH hormone level, follicle-stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, and normalize the sperm count of infertile men so they become fertile. Taseer DawaKhana Sperm Grow Course is prepared under the medical principle and proper scientific method with approved machinery in Taseer Pharma Limited. During the treatment, you should follow this precaution for better treatment results. Don't go for sex during the treatment. Use fish, eggs, milk, butter, honey, dates, lemon, garlic, pumpkin, radish, carrot, and dry fruits in your diet. Try to eat meat on daily basis. Abstain from the beef, rice, oily food, potatoes, bakery fruits, and junk food. Limit or abstain from alcohol and smoking. Avoid this. Avoid that lead to prolonged heat for the testicle. Keep the weight off. Steer clear of illicit drugs. So viewers, I briefly explained male infertility in my video. If you are not person have this problem, So you can visit our clinic or call us in our office timings, which is 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. and discuss your problem. I hope this video was informative and helpful for you. If you like this video, kindly subscribe our channel and click on the bell icon. I will see you again in my next video in which new disease topics and its treatment. It's time to say goodbye. Have a nice day. Take care. Allah Hafiz.